You know, I would be very happy if Sihlelonzi really is replacing Madam Mkhwebane. Because Madam Mkhwebane left the EFF, left a vacancy for anyone to come and replace her. Can be a young person, can be an old person. And with what I've been hearing, Sihlelonzi will be replacing Madam Mkhwebane in parliament, taking a spot. And many people are against it. They are saying, no, 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 not Sihlelonzi. He's still young. He's still emotionally intelligent. But even if he's still young, there is room for anyone to grow anywhere, whether in parliament, in politics. There's room for everyone to grow into the politics. You don't come there as a full package. That's why even Madam Mkhwebane, she's saying whatever role she was playing within the EFF and in parliament, it was overwhelming for her. You know why? Because it's just like that. It's just like that. It doesn't mean when you come with emotional intelligence or you come politically roasted and politically cooked, you're gonna go there and perform fully. No, you still have a job to do. You still have more research to do. You still have more things to do, more investigations to dive deep into for you to bring up and to understand whatever portfolio you are representing in parliament, whether you're old or young. So I support Sihlelonzi going to parliament because, first of all, it encourages us as young people to see that, yeah, there is young people in politics, there is young people in parliament, there is young people championing the rights of the youth of South Africa, not just the youth of the EFF, because the youth of South Africa is going to benefit, whether it's the EFF youth or ANC youth or MK party youth representing the youth in parliament. We're going to benefit because the voice will be a voice of a young person. The message will be relating to young people, whether EFF, MK party or whatever representative, as long as it's a youth and championing at the youth rights, or championing the dignity and the pride of young people, just to boost our confidence, to show us that we can do it. We can speak in parliament. We can speak and be heard. We can be in parliament and speak, even though that's not our aspirations. Indirectly so, it's gonna be motivating us, inspiring us to believe in ourselves as the youth, as the young people of South Africa. So I champion that. I support him going to parliament. And I wish other political parties were not so arrogant in trying to only deploy old people in parliament because somehow they have experience. They might have the experience, but they don't have the energy. They don't have the energy. Their energy doesn't look appealing and attractive. They don't have the oomph. So the youth can bring a certain environmental energy within parliament that will shake up things, that will just change the atmosphere. The parliament of South Africa is full of old people. All these different political parties, it's full of old people. Last time I checked Mr. Gateshead Mackenzie's political party, at least there was young people there. But the rest of the political parties, just bunch of old people. Old people in it for themselves, in it for their own agendas, wanna get a salary, feed their families. They don't care about what they are doing. They don't love it for what it is. They only care they get a salary, they don't have anything to do. Most of these old people, you wonder why they don't speak things that benefit your environment. They don't speak things that benefit you as a poor black person. It's because they're not in it for you. They're in it for what they are benefiting. They're getting paid from the IEC. So young people will bring a certain level of clarity and a certain level of immaturity compared to the old boring people in parliament always trying to be serious. Young people can bring the fun out of it, education out of it, entertainment out of it, and benefit the consciousness of the young people to focus on the politics. Because look, it's your time. It's not just old people. You too need to focus on this. Can't you see there's young people doing this? So it won't just benefit the EFF in parliament. It will benefit the young people of South Africa, their confidence, to see themselves worthy of becoming something greater because there's young people in parliament. It doesn't just have to be an EFF. It can be any party, like I say. It can be MK party putting a few young people there. It can be any party, ANC, putting, championing young people in parliament. Even if they don't have experience. For that matter that they don't have experience, it's going to boost a lot of youth confidence to show that, you know what, I can start from the bottom. Even though I'm up there playing with the world class, I can start from the bottom. Because look, guys, most of these old people, you are told they have experience. They might have experience, but the energy is not there. It's like, even the mindset, the intellect, the logic, it's not adding up because they're too old. They have so much they have to do at home, feed the kid, buy whatever. Young people, like, we don't have a lot of responsibilities. So it's like you have the time to do the research about whatever presentation you have to make. You have the time to bring up new ideas into the parliament, you know. So I champion young people who go into parliament. I champion it. Of course, not young people who are going to get there and do dumb things. Young people who are going to get there and perform well. You saw when they recently appointed Sinao Tambo. He got there, he challenged them, he did a wonderful job. Abo Naledi Chiro are doing a wonderful job. Abo Daideng Vuyano Pambo is even representing the FF together with Duduzile Zuma, who is representing the MK party in the Pan-Africanist movement, the Pan-Africanist parliament. These are young people. Yeah, one might be above 35, but they still have that appeal of youngness. They represent a young energy, and that energy is very attractive. Even from outsiders, people who are not interested in politics, they can see young people in South African politics and just get inspired and can give hope to the future of the country. So young people being in parliament will benefit the country in so many ways, not just the political party those people are representing, but the rest of the country. Even old people will be like, oh yeah, now I want to be too. Yes, they have this. They're continuing with the fight. They're continuing, you see. So I champion it. I champion it. I champion it. I champion it. It's a wonderful thing, you know, for young people to go to parliament. It's a wonderful thing the EFF is doing, uplifting the young voices. It doesn't have to be popular politicians who already have credentials and credit and street cred in the political scene. It can be people who were never known, but they have the intellect, they have the intelligence, they have the energy, the hard work. Most of these people who are praising every day that this one is a famous politician, they don't have the oomph. They don't have something about them. They lack that thing. You know why? Because they're old, but bakhathele. Young people, they're energetic, like nesbona thina skatali thina, skatali thina, skatali thina. Imagine me in parliament doing this, skatali thina, skatali thina. The parliament will be a movie, that will be a movie. Figure it out, skatali thina, skatali thina. Yeah, yadlala wena. But it is what it is. Thank you very much.